So exercise 1.2 is complete. Now we come to exercise 1.3. I had told you yesterday that this exercise is important. We have to prove numbers as irrational. And we are going to use a method called the contradiction method. Now, what is the meaning of contradiction here? Contradiction means it's not a direct proof. It's an indirect proof. Okay. I'll give you an example. Like in English language, contradiction means, for example, you are saying something. Don't shout, and you yourself are shouting. So that's a contradiction. Same way, suppose we want to prove something, like for example, if I want to prove that I'm using a pen, and what I'll do is I'll use an indirect proof, like there are two writing instruments. Okay, it's either a pencil or a pen. And if I'm able to prove that this is not a pencil, then obviously the result is that this is a pen. So that's the contradiction method. So same way here, mathematically now, prove that root 5 is an irrational number. So this is an important type of questions. Instead of root 5, you can get root 2, root 3, root 7, whatever. Okay, there are two solved examples also. You need to try out also those two questions because the numbers can obviously change in the exam. So the method is like this, contradiction. Let root 5 be a rational number. Okay, we have to prove it's irrational, but we are proving by a contradiction. Starting statement is opposite. Let root 5 be a rational number, and rational numbers you already know is in the form of p by q, where the denominator should not be 0. And here p and q are coprime numbers. Now those who don't know what is coprime, coprime numbers are numbers which do not have any common factor. So if you are having a number, let's say 6 and another number 8. Okay, now what is the factors of 6? 6 factor will be 2 and 3, and 8 will be 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 2, right? So here we are having a common factor 2. So these are not coprime. So when I am saying it is coprime, means it should not have a common factor. For example, if I am having the number 5 and let's say 7, or 5 and 6, there is no common factor. Of course, 1 is a factor for every number. So except for 1, there should be no common factor. So I can say 5 and 7 are coprime, or 5 and 6 are coprime. So here this assumption is important that it's a rational number, denominator should not be 0, and they are coprime. Now, since it's a rational number, we are equating root 5 as p by q. To remove the roots, we are squaring both sides. We get 5 equal to p square by q square. Cross multiply, we get p square equal to 5q square. So here we get an important conclusion that p square is 5q square. And yesterday we did some questions where I said that this number is very significant, 5. Because 5 into anything, whatever is the value of q, it will always be a multiple of 5. So the square of a number is a multiple of 5, which means the number is also a multiple of 5. So this is important, that p is a multiple of 5. Okay, because this 5 into anything, q could be any value, the p will always be a multiple of 5. So we can say p is equal to 5. M. Okay, I can write this in form of a variable m, where m stands for anything. So p equal to 5m. It's a multiple of 5. Now this value I'm going to substitute in equation 1. So p equal to 5m I'm putting here. So we get 5m whole square is equal to 5q square. So when we solve this, we get 25m square equal to 5q square. Cancel with 5, we get q square is equal to 5m square. So again, an important conclusion here that q is also a multiple of 5. If q square is a multiple of 5, q is also a multiple of 5. Again, this doesn't matter, whatever is the value of m. This number is important, that 5 into anything, okay, will be a multiple of 5. So q is also a multiple of 5. So what is the contradiction here? Here we are saying p is a multiple of 5. Q is also a multiple of 5. That means our assumption is false, because we had assumed in the beginning that p and q are which type of numbers? Coprime numbers. That means they do not have any common factor. But here we are finding that the common factor is 5, because p is a multiple of 5, q is also a multiple of 5, so there is a common factor of 5. So our assumption is false, and therefore we can say root 5 is irrational. So this is an important question, and in the exam any number can be given. So you need to practice this once on your own, and also please try the solved examples.